Hello, it's me again, Wolfram Greis from the European Mainframe Academy. And in this video clip, I want to talk about the cluster technique from IBM concerning the IBM mainframes. I want to talk about Sysplex, Parallel Sysplex, and GDPS. Let's start with the so-called base Sysplex environment. Base Sysplex means we can set up to 8 systems into one single image environment with different properties. All the systems have to be connected any to any with so-called signaling path. The operating systems running on these servers must have access to a set of DAST datasets called the Sysplex coupled datasets, where all the configuration is defined and a lot of parameters are set. These operating systems are running with the clocks synchronized on the different servers. This is really important for reasonable collaboration between these different operating systems. We have a so-called N-2 rule for hardware and software, means we can have a maximum of 3 different hardware generations and 3 different software generations in such a Sysplex configuration. But in many cases, that's enough because the work staff responsible for such an environment don't want to have different operating systems in a system environment, different versions of the operating systems, and normally they also don't have different hardware generations. Normally it's just a short time frame when we change, as example, from an operating version to the next level of the operating version, and then we have a mixture in such an environment of normally just 2 different generations. Parallel Sysplex means we have an additional device in place. Parallel Sysplex is also a synonym for data sharing, and data sharing means we have an additional device called the coupling facility, and this coupling facility is a shared memory shared between the operating system running in such a Sysplex environment. So the number of COS systems that can be set up is extended from 8 to 32, and we have at least 1 coupling facility for this data sharing I just mentioned. The general idea of Sysplex and Parallel Sysplex is the elimination of each and every SPOF. SPOF is an abbreviation for single point of failure, and we can eliminate these SPOFs with redundancy. Means each and every component have to be available at least twice. This means the servers by itself, the physical machines, the coupling facility, the FICON directors, the DAST subsystems, channel paths, coupling links, coupled datasets, and so on. All these components have to be at least twice in such an environment, because if one component fails, the other component can take over the work of the failing component. And the same is true for software. For software it means COS, the operating system, the middleware, subsystems, databases, message queuing, transaction systems, and so on, and of course also the applications. In such a coupling facility, we have a different set of structures. Structures is an area that is managed by such a coupling facility. So the coupling facility I mentioned already is the shared memory, and we have to have some processing power also in place to manage software and manage the so-called structures. We have 3 different structures. The most important structure are the so-called lock structures to set looks, especially in database environments. It's really important. There is a component running in each and every system. It's called the internal resource lock manager, managing locks that if we have different operating systems and different database management systems running in different machines and they access the same data, it has to be prevented that the same data is updated from another operating system, and that's why these lock structures are needed. We have also cache structures to store and retrieve large amounts of data. This is especially in place for shared database environments, for security data like RACF, and there are some other components using cache structures. List structures are used to store and retrieve data which comes in some kind of messages, means some journals or other things are managed, as example WebSphere MQ messages or IMS transactions. The next level when we talk about SysPlex and parallel SysPlex is GDPS. GDPS stands for geographically dispersed parallel SysPlex. It means we extend the idea of SysPlex and parallel SysPlex beyond one computer center. Means we combine or manage distributed SysPlexes. In this case, we can have complete site switches in case of outages without affecting transactions that are running. The key technologies that are in place in this case is parallel SysPlex, we just talked about it, is systems automation for COS, and there are two products or possibilities available to synchronize all the data. So if you want to have a high availability with GDPS, we have to synchronize the data in computer centers which take part in such a GDPS configuration. We have different disaster recovery tiers. I don't go in each and every detail here, but the most important thing is when we talk about disaster recovery configurations, there are two important things to mention. One is the data loss, means how many data are lost in case of a failure. And the second important thing is the recovery time, means how long does it take to get the system again up and running. And there are now different layers. It starts with the tier zero, so it means you have no disaster recovery plan. In this case, you lose, of course, all your data, and recovery time is not applicable, because if you don't have any data anymore, you can't do any recovery. And there are now different levels, and I want to emphasize now highest levels. It's GDPS, so you don't lose any data, and the recovery time is seconds. And there's a special configuration possible. It's called the active configuration. Means in each and every data center, the same applications are running, and we have a load balancer in place where the requests come in, and the load balancer decides this request goes to computer center one, and the next request goes to computer center two, or whatever, where the capacity is available to fulfill the request. And if a failure occurs, nothing happens at all, because all the transactions can run on the still available configuration. Active has the highest level of these disaster recovery tiers, with no data loss at all and with no recovery time, because it just runs on and on. Just to show you an example how such a configuration looks like, This is a typical configuration with two sites, and all the data in these two sites are synchronized. All the disk devices, all the tape devices have the same data available in both computer centers. And in this case, we have just two machines, a C14 in a site 1 and a C14 in a site 2, and a lot of LPaaS working together to setting up such a Sysplex environment. There are a lot of Redbooks available if you want to go into more detail. Redbooks are really important papers to show you how different scenarios can look like, and a lot of introductional material concerning such kind of configurations. Yeah, this was the Sysplex, Parallel Sysplex and GDPS video clip. Have fun, and we see and hear us in one of the next video clips. Thank you very much for attending.